You might have heard the term tokenization thrown around and you're curious, what exactly does that mean? Well, you come to the right place. We're going to cover this in business terms that all of us can understand. Let's dig in. First off, it's important to understand that tokenization is an industry standard, and it's more or less required by the PCI DSS for all organizations that take credit cards. Now, that's not to say that it's impossible to be PCI compliant without using tokenization. However, it does become much more challenging. Tokenization is a technology that was developed industry-wide to ensure that cardholder data is kept secure. This is accomplished by the receiver of the cardholder data assigning a random string of characters and returning that string to the provider of the cardholder data. Okay, I promise we'd talk about this in simple business terms, so let me try that again. In short, us merchants, we give the credit card number through encryption to a trusted partner, most likely your payment gateway. The payment gateway will in turn give you a reference that represents that credit card in their system, but just for you. Now, a token, it cannot be deciphered because it wasn't encrypted. Instead, this is a random string that's assigned to that credit card number that you, the merchant, gave to that gateway. I guess this probably makes sense for most of us. However, I've come up with a kind of simple analogy that I think paints the picture pretty well, and it also helps us understand how the system is secure. Okay, let's say that you go to Las Vegas to play blackjack. And let's also say that you start off the MGM Grand, where you sit down at a table, you hand them $100, and they hand you back 20 $5 tokens. And while you're in the MGM Grand, those tokens are essentially as good as cash money. Now let's say that you win 100 bucks from them, and then you walk across the street to go to New York, New York. Now, you may know that New York, New York is actually owned by MGM. However, your tokens from the MGM Grand are not going to work at the New York, New York. They are only currency at the MGM Grand. If you were to put them on the table at New York, New York, you'd be told that you can't play with them. They're just no good there. So I believe that this is a solid analogy for the payments industry and how we work with tokens. A token that you get from your payment gateway is only good when you, the merchant, are signed in to that payment gateway. The tokenized card data might be able to be shared across multiple MIDs, and that does happen from time to time, and something you should talk to your payment gateway about if that's something you need. But this is a big part of what makes this system so secure, because if a disgruntled employee or some other sort of attacker manages to get their hands on these tokens, they're of no use to them. Even if this would-be attacker somehow also got your credentials and got signed into your gateway account, they still would be unable to use those tokens to get any money, as those tokens are tied through your merchant ID to your bank account. Even if this attacker did try to charge something against the token, the money would be in your bank account, fully within your control for you to reverse. If you wanted to dive deeper into the technical details, there's many other videos here on YouTube that will explain that in whatever detail you want to understand. I'm hopeful that this video helps some of us business users better understand the value that tokens can bring to our businesses and why we should all be using them. It's worth noting that there's sometimes a cost that your gateway is going to tack on to tokenize that cardholder data for you. And it's also noteworthy that most gateways now will also tokenize bank account data for all of us. So both cards and accounts can be tokenized. And the value, I feel like it's easy to see. If you're not storing customers' credit card numbers, then you couldn't be at fault if they end up in the wrong hands. At Chargent, we recommend that all of our customers tokenize all of their card data that they use throughout their entire organization. To facilitate this, we have developed our API, our payment console, and our payment request features to ensure that the protected cardholder data that you've been entrusted with is never stored inside the Salesforce system for any amount of time. Have questions about anything we've talked about here? Well, feel free to drop a question in the comments below, or you can also click the link here on your screen to get in touch with us. The Chargent team is always here to help. Hey, thank you for watching our video. And while you're here, please subscribe to our channel. Click that notification bell for immediate updates. And if you'd like to talk payments, please get in touch. We're always here to help.